Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary, Innovation Station. Happy anniversary to you. So again, guys, this is for you all for 3 years. So may God continue to bless and open doors of opportunity. So I just speak blessings over Innovation Station as Ish, you are the leader, and for the core team that have really been there, for those of you that have been from inception, you know, may God just continue to use you as a willing vessel to continue to impact the lives of others as you are, as your shirt says, the mentor.
Thank you.
All
right. Can't blow it out one more.
Come on, guys. This is all you. This is all, no spitting on the tape, though, okay?
A typical day at Innovation Station is a day that you can't call typical because change is always created. Innovation Station is a sales and marketing firm that outsources with Fortune 500 companies, and we handle all of their sales and marketing campaigns. What made me want to start Innovation Station? Innovation Station, the name comes from all of the individuals that were in my life, no matter whether they came prematurely or at a time in need. They put me in an atmosphere where I could change, and that's what Innovation Station is. It's a station for innovation. It's one of those things that you cannot depict what a day is going to be like in Innovation Station. It's something that you just have to come and see.
Innovation Station is a place where you really get to take your talents that was God-given and make them into whatever you want to. It is a even playing field, and it's a way for your creative juices to really flow out where you can display them to the world without nobody having this little voice that's saying, you can't do that. You got a lot of people that's encouraging and cheering you on behind your vision.
Well, the cool thing about Innovation Station is it's not your traditional employee job, so to speak. It's more of a, you know, personal development. So, you know, you actually becoming a better person throughout the program.
You know, the minute we come in, we excited. Like, excitement is everything.
It's very live, very impact at all times. When you walk in the room, when you walk in the door that's not even ours, when you first walk in, you're gonna hear the music pump. It's a mood setter, and it really says, hey, it's time. As soon as you walk in, you know it's time to play.
Attitude is everything. I always had an attitude issue growing up, and I learned here that attitude, you know, is the beginning. You can't do nothing without attitude. You can't learn, or you can't really gain any experience or knowledge if your attitude's not right. So the moment we come in the door, we yell.
Hey guys! Hey guys! Hey guys!
Hey guys!
Hey guys! Bring that Friday!
Yeah!
Get all that out. Get that excitement, that attitude, that energy out in the air, and let everybody know we here, we innovate. And then
words can't even express how great this man is, because the cool thing about Ishmael is his integrity is just something that you want to try to model and you want to strive for. I mean, he's just as open-minded as possible that I ever seen in a human being, and he's just always upfront about everything. So with just that right there, you know, you do your best to strive to that and model that. I mean, he leads by example every day.
Every person has something inside of them that motivates them to action, because that's what motivation is. What's their motive of action?
The difference between the winners and the losers is the conditions that they make up in their mind that losers are uncomfortable doing. And that's what losers would have did.
And you cannot, like, put motivation towards just one specific way. Everybody's different. And you have to really develop a personal relationship with the guys that you serve. And you have to really be willing to get out of your comfort zone to tap into their world. And I spend a lot of my time in their world understanding where they are. Because if I don't meet them where they are, I can't bring them where I am. And if you really want to have progress in any organization, you got to meet guys where they are. And my best motivation tool is meeting individuals right where they are.
Cause we a team now.
Yeah,
we really winning.
Okay.
We the dream now.
Turn up.
Yes, innovate.
Innovate.
Yes, how we play.
Yeah,
we get it.
Hey,
every day.
Because, hey, this is our three-year anniversary. You know what happened to us our first year? They told us that they weren't going to pay us for 7 weeks. We already didn't have no money. You know what most people do when they don't get paid for 1 week? Quit. So you telling me I would have let 7 weeks talk me out of $2 million? People let minor things talk them out of big opportunities. This thing finna go on camera.
Ishmael is so much of a team player that he demands that when you're around him. Even if you're not one, you become one just by being around him. You have to be.
The atmosphere that just brings the synergy and the camaraderie of the team together and make sure that we're all in one accord.
The best thing I probably like about it is the teamwork. Definitely being with a team, because you're never by yourself, and it's like we're always in it together.
When we go out there, we're not just knocking the door by ourselves, we're knocking the door at the team. Even though we're there individually, the whole team is there with you. Through spirit, we all together. And so we do activities like that that come together, you know, and because, you know, whatever, the biggest thing I learned, whatever we go through here in the office, we're going to experience in the field because we all people.
So, you know, you always got somebody behind your back throughout all the midst of the challenges.
My secret is, I was one of those individuals that was, I felt, quote unquote, that I was not set up to win. I was one of those individuals that was rejected, that was put down, that was like told that, hey, you can't do it this way. And so when I recruit, I attract people like that. And the younger adults, I haven't always had younger adults, but the young adults came from the impact that I was able to make on my little brother and another guy. At one time, everyone that worked alongside of me was older than me. And they would achieve all of the success, but it would really not do anything for the community. And I thought that if I could really put in the effort and sacrifice all of my skills and everything on the front end, I could really affect a lot of communities on the back end. You gotta reward people how they wanna be rewarded. I feel like all humans got six basic needs. You know, they got like a need for certainty. They got a need for uncertainty. They got a need for significance. They got a need for love and connection. They got a need for contribution. And they got a need for growth. You gotta find out which one of those mean the most to them. And you reward them accordingly. I feel like sometimes people reward individuals after they do the job. I think that in the beginning phases of any organization, you need to reward individuals before they do the job. That you need to let individuals know that you appreciate them even thinking about being able to handle some of the Everest tasks that you're willing to give them. And they are more apt to take on larger opportunities because they are operating out of a spirit of love instead of fear. And I love the feeling that I have in the room, and I make sure that it stays that way. Freestyle Friday came from a reward When we were starting 2 years ago, we were given this gigantic target in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and it was a target that was completely out of our comfort zone. And we had to figure out how could I do something to motivate these individuals. And one day I asked him, I said, if you could embarrass me, what would you have me do? And collectively, they said, we would want you to freestyle for 30 seconds. 2 years ago, I don't recall ever attempting to freestyle. And I bet them if they did 10 sales in one day, and at this time it was only 5D, that's like a 2 per rep average, and that's like probably the most in the country. And I bet them, I challenged them that, hey, if you guys do this, I will freestyle for you for 30 seconds. And that night when they came back, guess what? They had 10 sales. And so when announcements came the next morning, as I was gathering my courage up, one of them said, double or nothing. This kind of got me tearing up, because
is it?
Yeah, but the tears are for the grind that we saw to, like, thank you, to make that part happen, to see how much of growth that I have had on the freestyle portion has excited them even more. Since we started Freestyle Friday, I mean, we doubled our sales, you know, in like 8 weeks. So we went from, you know, in the middle of the pool from most companies to now one of the sole providers for our clients. The first 3 years was for the mission. I can tell you that. The first 3 years was to build a real solid foundation. I still feel energized, ambitious, persistent. I still feel like we have so much more to go. The next 3 years is for the team. I have so many individuals that sacrificed a lot of things to help me on my mission. And I'm going to spend the next 3 years of my life sacrificing to help them get to where they are.